All right.
Oh, I forgot to tell you about your job. You have a job. That is, when the band comes out, you should probably clap. That would be a good idea. And they're going to come out about 1 minute before we go live. We will have this voice of God countdown going, 10, 9, 8.
1 minute.
Got it. When he gets down to the 8-second mark, you should clap really, really loud, because that's when everybody who's listening at home, including your dogs or cats, who are still listening from Listener Appreciation Day, will get to hear you. All right. Radio 104.5 Philadelphia, please welcome to the stage, Pixies. Out to Weezer / Toto until then.
Thank you.
It is a glorious morning at Radio 104.5. We meet again. Pixies are here in Philadelphia. Our AT&T Thanks Sound Studio. We are celebrating a new album out exactly 1 week from today, Beneath the Eerie. We have music. We have so many things to talk about, a podcast I'm obsessed with. But it's music first here at Radio 104.5. Pixies, stage is yours.
Thank you very much for coming out this morning. And this is a song called Catfish Kate.
Call me devil, call me friend, but call me blackjack hooligan. I came all the way from Aberdeen to live among the go-betweens. Let me tell you about Catfish Kate, in the time before when she's just Kate. Here in the mountains all alone, before the time we called this home. Where is my angel falling? Down at the river bottom, and will she get away? Where is my blackfoot blossom? Is she just playing possum? Who lives another day? Here in the valley that we all know, a river bend that's deep and slow, where every creature drinks their fill and other creatures take their kill. Now Kitty went to catch a fish to put inside her favorite dish. A catfish grabbed her by the head, yeah, took her to his house instead. Where is my angel falling? Down at the river bottom, and will she get away? Where is my blackfoot blossom? Is she just playing possum? Who lives another day? They wrestled all the day and night, the morning show, the bloody sight. Kate all dressed in catfish clothes, there's whiskers for her catfish robe, whiskers for her robe. Where is my angel falling? Down at the river bottom, and is she there to stay? Where is my blackfoot blossom? Is she just playing possum? Who lives another day? And now she's known as Catfish Kate.
Thank you.
We are live in our AT&T Bank Sound Studio with Pixies on Radio 104.5. Catfish Kate, which is off of the new album out next Friday, Beneath the Eerie. So it's a Pixies podcast. Is this beautiful thing that I've been devouring and obsessed with, recording every single moment in the creative process in the studio over the course of 3 weeks back in December. Historically, like in the music business, we get these emails all the time, confidential, it's under lock and key. There's always this secrecy. This is the complete opposite. You're sharing bits and pieces of all of these songs before we get to hear them as complete works of art. Whose idea was it? Did it take any convincing? Was there any apprehension behind that, Charles?
I don't know whose idea it was, but we did two podcast episodes before this podcast when we were making the demos that Paz produced, and they were too crazy for prime time. So they brought in some squares to kind of like rein it in a little bit, and that is what is streaming now, at Spotify or places like that, or wherever they stream things.
All of the places, including iHeartRadio. Pause, do you feel like somebody took your baby away from you?
No, but maybe it's for the better, you know.
Well, you had to focus on, you know, playing and all of that.
Good point.
You know, doing your job. The studio in upstate New York around Woodstock in an old church, and its location and surroundings directly inform the album title. David, this is a question for you. We were talking before that I didn't even know the word eerie until this album title came out. You know an awful lot about it. So A, tell us the word, and it's not like spooky, scary eerie, and it's not spelled that way. And tell me about the inspiration.
Well, I love Birds of Prey. And just where the church we were, we were told it was an eagle's nest in the back. I don't know the scientific name of the bald eagle, but there was a huge nest out there. Otherwise known, most Birds of Prey, eerie nests. There's different derivations of the spelling. But everyone loved watching it. We didn't see the eagle. I don't know if anyone did. But the nest was there, and that was the inspiration for the name of the album. So
place definitely in the DNA of this album. Albums used to come out on Tuesdays for a very, very long time. So this is a newish consideration. Was there any thought whatsoever, Joey, in it's Friday the 13th. We're going to put our album out on a sort of superstitious kind of day. Did anybody have any issues with that?
I'm more concerned about the notes I just played wrong, but is it Friday the 13th now?
Next Friday, really, when the album comes out.
Friday the 13th? Well, yeah, it probably has significance. I think back then, records were released on Tuesdays,
right,
or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter now.
Okay.
It just drops out of the cloud.
Yeah.
Stormy cloud.
Ooh.
Dark cloud.
Ooh,
on
I like
Friday
it.
The 13th.
I like it. Charles, the band recorded three covers during the sessions, correct? Can you remind me what they were and what the plan might be for them? Like, are we going to get to hear these things?
No. There's a T-Rex song. What was that T-Rex song?
Mambo Sun.
Yeah, Mambo Sun. And then there was an attempt at a Captain Beefheart song called Grow Fins, but I sort of blew it on that one. And so you'll definitely not hear that one until I get my stuff together. And then there was a song by the Only Ones called The Whole of the Law. And we did a pretty good version of it, but I think we need to do it again still. It's not quite
So there, yeah.
But anyway, we did a few covers. But
okay, all right. It was sort of a tease, like, no, but here are all these awesome things we tried. So something for you in the future. So I know that we have a world premiere of a song coming from Beneath the Eerie, and we're going to do that a little bit later, but right now you have something else you're going to play for us.
Yes, someone asked for Monkey Gone to Heaven, so we'll do that right now. There was a guy
an underwater guy who controlled the sea. Got killed by 10 million pounds of sludge from New York and New Jersey. This monk is gone to heaven. 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 The creature in the sky got sucked in a hole. Now there's a hole in the sky. And the ground's not cold. And if the ground's not cold, everything is gonna burn. Well, I'll take turns. I'll get mine too. This monkey's gone to heaven. This monkey's gone. Rock me, Joey. If man is five, if man is five, if man is five, then the devil is six. Then the devil is six. The devil is six. The devil is six. And if the devil is six, then God is seven. God is seven. This monkey's gone to heaven. This monkey's gone to heaven. This monkey. This monkey's gone to heaven. 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 This monkey.
In our AT&T Thanks Sound Studio. We are here to celebrate a new album, and we are going to do that as we continue live on radio1045.com. So if you're listening on the radio right now, you got to get to your computer, to your phone, radio1045.com, because we have a world premiere of a new Pixies song for you. As we continue over there, for everybody else, throwing it back to the studio with Pixies. Okay, so we're on the web. We're good. If you want to swear now, you can. Get it out of your system. So I fell in love with this song this morning. The new episode of the podcast is all about Daniel Boone, which is sort of a ballad, if it were. And it's weird because I've never fallen in love with a song before I've heard the actual song. So it was a very strange, awesome sort of thing. And I had this like idea of, you know, they always talk about it's the journey, not the destination. And the beauty of that is definitely celebrated in these, 13 episodes or whatever of the podcast. And especially this morning for me and Daniel Boone. Charles, do you want to tell me about it a little bit?
About Daniel Boone? Yeah. It's one of the songs on the record. And let me see what else what can I say about it? It's not about Daniel Boone. although, thank you, Daniel Boone, for lending us your name. Moon, June, Spoon, Boone. So we broke out of that, found a new oon. And what else is it? It's got a key change in it, that very dramatic key change there at the last chorus. So that was kind of, we don't do that a lot, do a key change, which might be standard in other forms of popular music. But anyway, we did a key change, which is quite dramatic.
We're not here to talk about other forms of music. We're here to talk about Pixies. I can't wait to hear the finished product on Beneath the Eerie on Friday, a week from today. Joey, I want you to talk to me a little bit about the role of producer. So Tom Dougherty, it's very apparent when you're listening to all this behind-the-scenes stuff that somebody who's not on stage with you now or every night when you're out playing, you almost... As an outsider, forget, you know, you forget about that. It seems like you had an incredible working relationship. It seemed incredibly amicable and collaborative. Tell me about Tom.
Well, he was fucking awesome and head carrier. And then he just became more fucking awesomer, like goddamn motherfucking awesome. And then, you know, the next record's probably going to be fucking off. Goddamn fucking hook, because he's a motherfucker.
You're really taking that and running with it.
Just gets out of my system. I really don't fucking swear that much. I used to fucking swear a lot, actually. I worked at the docks, yeah. But
I'll let you keep going if you want.
No fucking thank you.
From docks to surfing, pause. There's two very surf-specific songs on the album. That's all you. You're the resident surfer for the band, yes?
Yes, and also, you know, the first record is Surfer Rosa, and there are some surfy songs on that, but I happen to be the surfer of the band, and yeah, I took a pass at some words.
Okay, tell me the two songs again.
It's called Los Surfers Muertos, which means the dead surfers.
I thought it was the motherfucking surfer.
And Long Rider. Long meaning like a longboarder.
And
the Long Rider.
One of those songs pays tribute to a friend that had an accident, yeah?
Yeah, had an accident surfing and passed away. And, you know, if you are doing what you love and you pass away doing it, I don't know, maybe it's not so bad.
I like that. There's a new show, TV show, that I just heard about called Surfing Rocker, musicians that are surfers, obviously. It's going to debut in February, but I guess like Eddie Vedder and Jack Johnson and Billy Joe Armstrong are going to be featured. Do you end up running into other musicians that are surfers and having this sort of instant bond? And did they ask you to be on it? And if not, why not?
They didn't ask me to be on it. Yeah, I guess I run into people. I try to surf by myself or go to places where I don't run into people. And I think life has enough of saying hi in land, and I rather say goodbye and, you know, in the sea and not talk to anybody or run into anybody.
It's beautiful. Charles, you paint as another artistic, getting it out of your system output as another artistic thing. Do those paintings see the light of day?
No.
Just for you.
Not yet.
They're hanging out with those covers we're never going to hear.
They're still drying, you know.
All right, we have a momentous occasion, a world premiere of a new song from Pixies from Beneath the Eyrie. I believe it's Mark of Cain.
Yeah, this is called, we call it Cain. I think the actual title is In the Arms of Mrs. Mark of Cain.
Like a grouse who's resigned to the blade. If you die, Thane. In the arms of Mrs. Barbara Kay. My memories are all fables, so I'm trying to get at the truth. And if you think I am able, well, I got some news for you. I'm in the arms of Mrs. Mark of Kent. But it feels so damn good, so I know I'll be staying. No, I'm not underfoot, I've been trying to explain. I'm in the arms of Mrs. Mark of Cain. I'm in the arms of Mrs. Mark of Cain. In the arms of Mrs. Martha King.
Thank you very much.
Radio 104.5 and iHeartRadio live with Pixies world premiere in the arms of Mrs. Mark of Cain. Live, of course.
Thanks for having us.
We couldn't be any more thankful. The new album, Beneath the Eerie, is out next Friday. Pre-order it, pre-save it, get it, and listen to the It's a Pixies podcast. Pixies, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.